या देवी सर्वभूतेषु शक्ति रूपेण संस्थिता, या देवी सर्वभूतेषु मात्र रूपेण संस्थिता, शी इज द पावर द लाइफ ऑफ ऑल यूनिवर्स, द वन हु होल्ड्स होल एज अ मदर फुल ऑफ लाइफ विच वी ऑल आर फॉरगेटिंग टू प्रोटेक्ट एज शी इज द सल्यूशन द मेडिकेशन. माई हार्ट फुल ग्रेटिट्यूड टू द वेल नोन डिग्निटरीज ऑन द डायस, organizing committee and all the other participants, myself Love Thakur representing district Valsar, standing in front of you today to share my thoughtfulness on my today's chosen topic, that is harnessing the power of women. Before I chose this topic, I went on a survey to meet different categories of women such as working women, household women, educated women, uneducated women and a single woman, to witness the term power in my today's chosen topic. Because since so many years, we have been talking about women empowerment, women power, but I actually wanted to take the moment and I wanted to ask every individual woman about their perception of power. Where a household woman complains about not getting respect and the appreciation for her unstoppable work she does because all she does is household chores. Where a single divorcee woman complains about her cruel husband, how he used to fully being drunk and used to come home and used to beat her and her children, which isn't a new story. In India, over 16 women out of 100 still suffers domestic violence in some form. For women like them, the day when no man being fully drunk will not harass their family members will be the day they will conquer power. And then I came along to a working woman who she was already feeling powerful. I asked, ma'am, what's your secret about powerful? She replied me with just two words, that was financial freedom. Today, a woman can walk the pathway of confidence, success, and freedom if she is financially free. But what is the foundation of financial freedom? The financial freedom can be achieved with education. The overall literacy rate in India, compared with the rest of the developed countries, the female literacy rate is 60% low. The reasons are basic. Male-dominated society. Well, if we have came this across, how can we forget the biggest obstacle in women's pathway of success? That is rape culture. Yes, it is difficult to be a woman in our Indian society where a man rapes 8-month-old baby to a 100-year-old woman, where girls are told to how to dress just to avoid inviting troubles. It's an immediate necessity for change. Well, I feel women, it is a high time where every woman should wake up and realize their power. Women, you are so superior that you can't even compare with men, where it is a high time where every woman should realize their superiority. The best epitome I can give is of Bilkis Dadi, 82-year-old activist, shows that it is never too late to fight for what you believe in. Even our Indian government is trying best with its great initiatives like Din Dayal Upadhyay Antyodaya Yojana, providing best support to the rural women. With, at the same time, Beti Bachao Beti Padhao Abhiyan, where no daughter is denied the right to education. Entrepreneurship programs have been developed for women so that every woman can achieve what they aspire for. I truly feel every woman should acknowledge the skills and show their best activation and participation. Jawaharlal Nehru said, if we really want to awaken the people, it is the woman who must be awakened so that the nation moves and the village moves and the family moves. Lastly, I would like to conclude my speech with these two lines. That is, agar hame sach mein karna hai rashtra nirman, to karna hoga har mahila ke sapno ka samman. कोई उसके पाओ को ना जकड़े, कोई उसकी आवाज को ना दबोचे, क्योंकि तब जा